We're joined by today's guest, Ruthie Henshall, who's here, Faye Ripley, butcher Charlotte Harbottle, and explorer David Hempelman Adams. They're still with us over there, and David was just telling us about how he builds up weight before he goes on expedition. And you were saying that since you've been doing Billy Elliot, you've lost...
I've lost a stone. But that is the nature of the show. You know, when you're doing 8 shows a week, especially when you're dancing, and I'm singing, dancing, yeah, a little bit of comedy, a little bit of everything in it, and you're up and downstairs, costume changing and what have you. It's 2.5 hours of sort of being an athlete, really, I suppose. And when I'm not doing a show, I'm a lazy bag, really.
You just say, I'm going to go on an expedition soon. That's why I'm doing it. So how's it been going, Billy Elliot?
Absolutely brilliant. I'm totally in love with these kids. I thought I was one of the people who, you know, you love your own kids, but when somebody else's kids come around for a play date, you know, you're like, yep, 2.5 hours and then they're out, please. Oh. But I didn't realise how much I love children, and I'm mad about them. They're
how
brilliant.
Many are there of them?
Well, there's 3 sets of ballet girls, and I think there's about 10 or 12 in each of those. And then there's 3 Billies. No, there's 5 Billies at the moment. 3 Michaels and 3 Debbies. So,
do you have a favourite Billy?
Do you know what? They really are so different.
Yeah, but do you have a favourite one? Yeah.
Not being sucked into that one.
You know you do.
So that's Elliot. Oh my goodness, he's so good in it.
Right. So what's interesting is they filmed it one night.
Yes.
And they put it to cinemas.
500 cinemas.
500
I think.
Cinemas.
I think it went to. It might have been a little bit more, but it went to 500 cinemas.
Is that the first time it's ever been done?
Yes. I don't think a musical's ever been apart from a concert performance.
They do it with ballet, don't they? My mum goes to watch that.
Ballet, opera.
Yeah.
And the National, I think, have done it. But we're the first musical who've done it, and I think we were the third grossing film for Universal ever, and that weekend we beat Batman for
it's incredible,
isn't it?
Did you all think it was going to be that successful?
No, I don't think we knew the musical was brilliant, but you don't know when you're doing something like a live performance to TV. To cinemas, whether anyone's going to go. Mm. But what's so fantastic is that people who can't normally either make the journey physically or can't afford to go to the theatre, because let's be honest, if you're going to the theatre, you've not only got the price of a ticket, you've got your car park or your congestion charge,
ice cream at half-time.
Ice cream at half-time. Pint in the pub.
Yeah.
You know, it really grows. So, you know, for the sake of £10 or £20, whatever it was, wherever you were, you got to see a West End musical
and be in that actual performance.
Absolutely, yeah. And it was done live from start to finish. We did it as we normally did, and at the end, they got 27 of the old Billies, who ranged from 24 years old to 11, and they all did what they called this mashup, and they were amazing. I mean, and where their lives have taken them because they were in Billy Elliot is quite astounding. I think apart from one who's got a tattoo shop now and was covered in tattoos, brilliant. They were flipping, dancing, turning, and you think that it really did change their lives, that show.
All right, well, listen, we'll talk and we'll carry on talking. So we're going to make crab cakes today. Yes. So we've got some beautiful white crab, then we've got some breadcrumbs, some eggs, some mayonnaise, some red pepper, green pepper, then some red onions, some celery, and then we've got avocados, creme fraiche, and lots of limes, which you're going to make an avocado puree from. How are your knife skills, Ruthie Henshall?
Well, we'll see if I got my fingers at the end.
Fine. I know.
No. Tuck them away.
We're on a bad run with kind of making guests cut themselves. So what we need from the celery, down like that, and then that kind of size. All right. Timothy, would you like to do a pepper or an onion?
Let's see.
I'll do an onion. That's good.
An onion. I get a little bit of fine dice on that. So all we'll do with this, we're just making a tasty crab cake mix.
There's the DVD out, isn't there, of the live show?
Well, yes. What we did was they took some bits and they filmed a few bits and pieces on the couple of days beforehand. The show that they saw in the cinema was live, start to finish, but they did some cutaways so that they could make a DVD. And that came out yesterday.
Is flipping Billy Elliot on there?
Flipping Billy Elliot.
Yeah. Is he?
Yeah.
Tattoo Billy Elliot.
Tattoos on there.
Scary Billy Elliot.
Scary. I think it was probably very hard because, you know, a lot of my dresser has been on it for 10 years, and Now, hopefully you will see the humour in this. I came into the show, and this is the kind of dresser I have. It's actually her dressing room. We call it her dressing room because she's been there for 10 years. She's quite a formidable lady who will tell you exactly as is. And I was standing there one day, and I said, I hate these trousers. I said, oh, God. And I was complaining about it, well, quietly, sort of saying, oh, don't like these. She said, darling, they're not looking at you. They're looking at the kid. And she saw my
face.
I was waiting for her to go, not really. She went, no, really.
No, really.
So I got the lay of the land pretty quickly, which, you know, it is. It's all about the boy. And on the DVD, it's a boy called Elliot Hannah who stepped up to the plate. How he... I mean, he was 11 years old, and under all that pressure, going nationwide, it also went to America, into cinemas in America, in Europe, in Australia. And so you've got this enormous opportunity. Didn't flinch. Didn't break a sweat.
An old pro.
Right, job for you. So